FPV differs from normal drone flying in that you're seeing the view from the camera, so your left is always left, right is always right. There's no reverse controls. If you're flying straight towards yourself, it doesn't matter. You're always as if you were sitting in it, and that makes it really intuitive. Yeah, instead of looking up with your eyes, what we call line of sight flying, it's as if you're sitting in it. There's loads of types of flying that you can do with FPV that you couldn't hope to do with line of sight, just because you're getting that viewpoint right there. Whereas if you're looking at it from a distance away, you couldn't judge whether, am I that side of that obstacle or am I this side of it? Obviously, when you're in the aircraft, as it were, you can tell that. You see a lot of shots in movies now where it's not like a traditional drone going back sort of 10 years where it's a very stabilized, gimbaled shot, you know, big wide pan shot. It's more of a dynamic in and out, through stuff, under stuff, you know, and there's big move with advertising type shots where what they call a fly through, where the drone literally flies through a bar or through a bowling alley or through whatever it is you're trying to market. And often there's actors there pretending they don't see the drone. And yeah, it's become very popular for that. So obviously this is on and you can see it's gimbaling as I move it forward and back, but there's no gimbal in any of the other axes. So, but with rocksteady mode, you can still have that horizontal stabilization, because what it's doing, this is quite a big sensor, it crops in slightly and sort of keeps the section of the shot that you're going to use is the cropped element in the middle, and it uses the gyro data to give you that final stabilized shot. So whilst in reality I'm doing this and the camera's doing that, the final shot is horizon steady. It's the horizon is straight. And there's a third option for that as well, where you have it in neither of those modes. They call them EIS modes. You have it in a third one where it just records the gyro data, and then you put it into software on your computer, which takes the footage and the gyro data and merges them, uses both of those bits of information to do the same job, but some people say better than horizon steady. So it gives you the same result. You get a beautifully stabilized image, but it's done it all on the PC. So the Avata 2 comes with the motion controller. I think it's called the motion controller 2 because there was one previously. Does it say on it? Which I think is great. And first of all, I was flying with just that. I've recently got this, which is sort of an optional extra, which is the, I think it's called controller 2. That's the antenna. And other than that, it's fairly self-explanatory. So that's much more traditional. Obviously you've got your throttle there, then you've got your yaw axis, and then pitch and roll. And unlike this, where you're doing that motion and then just squeezing the trigger to go, or pushing the trigger backwards to go backwards, this is more traditional. You're doing coordinated turns, so you're having to do a little bit of yawing and a little bit of rolling to go around a nice smooth turn, etc. It's more traditional, shall we say. I'm really enjoying flying drones by FPV, partly because these goggles are amazing, and the quality of the signal, the transmission, the size of the picture in your goggles, the robustness of the signal is just epic, and like nothing we've seen previously. And you really feel like, I think it's the size of the image in the goggles, you really feel like you can see all around, because it's all digital, like high definition, frequency hopping, spread spectrum stuff that's really revolutionized the sort of FPV robustness, the quality of the image.
Yeah.
You're not getting fuzzy lines or anything like that. You're just seeing basically high definition in your goggles. So to fly FPV safely and lawfully in the UK, you have to have a competent observer. So that's someone who can keep an eye on the airspace, keep an eye out for low-flying helicopters or whatever it may be, and that person has to be stood adjacent to you and be properly briefed. So you just agree that if your spotter were to see something approaching, what they would say. And our suggestion in our handbook is aircraft, descend, descend, descend. Unless there's an aircraft coming in really low that's below your drone, and then they might say aircraft, climb, climb, climb. But really it's whatever you agree, as long as the two of you know what your methodology is, that if something's coming, you're gonna get out the way of it. Other than that, make sure you've got a space that's free of obstacles and safe. There's not people picnicking or high tension power lines or whatever. Pick a nice spot, quiet spot, and enjoy yourselves.